Hey, my brother and sister. Hope you are doing well this afternoon. Listen, I wanted to just take a moment and jump on and put out a word in the midst of everything going on to hopefully help bring some peace and some resolve to this land. One of the questions that I've been asking is where or who is the voice that can help bring calm and peace in the midst of such chaos? And I realize that it may not just be one in particular voice, but the voices has to be unified, and it may be different people, but speaking the same thing. I wanted to make sure that my voice was a part of that as a pastor and as a leader, to come and implore you, my brothers and sisters, to hopefully help bring peace and calm in the middle of everything going on. Listen, there is something called righteous indignation, but righteous indignation is not going to go and put you and others in harm's way. You're not going to go out and destroy other people's property. You're going to protest if that's what you want to do, but make sure that your protest brings about positive results. Of course, we as men and women of God are already praying, and we're going to continue to pray, because the Bible is clear that the fervent and effectual prayers of a righteous man or woman avail much. We're going to pray, but we want to do things that will bring about positive results. So I'm asking you, please, 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 make sure that if you're protesting, if you're out there doing that, do it in a way so that you can come home. Do it in a way so that it brings some help and healing to our land. This dear brother Floyd, who lost his life, and so many others who, yes, have wrongfully been killed. We do want to stand up for that, but we also want to make sure that we do it in a manner that will bring some healing to our land. I also want to implore you, in the midst of everything going on, to be careful, because the enemy is cunning. And while many are out there protesting, there is no physical distance. And some are not wearing masks. And the enemy will use these type of tactics to cause more sickness and virus spread and things like that. So please, I implore you to please be careful. Do things the right way. Honor God. God knows how to bring about change better than we can. Remember this, the Bible says, righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. Don't give place to the devil. Stand for right, stand for righteousness. Be safe. Come home tonight. And I believe that as we trust God, He will bring about positive results. Stay encouraged, my brother. I'm just one voice of many. We can do this together. God bless you.